In this video, we are going to look at passive range of motion assessment of the shoulder. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The goal of passive range of motion assessment is to assess the osteokinematic movements of a joint, to evaluate the range of motion in degrees, and if motion is limited, to assess the end feel. A collection of different end feels can be seen in this table. Oftentimes, you will see differences between the dominant and non-dominant side, which is completely normal and does not have to correlate with symptoms. According to a study done by Werner et al. In 2014, shoulder passive range of motion assessment had substantial inter-radar reliability in healthy subjects and significant inter-radar reliability in symptomatic individuals, with an innovative approach using a smartphone inclinometer performing the best. Let's first take a look at forward flexion in the glenohumeral joint. With the patient sitting on the bench, place one hand on the scapula and clavicle to fixate both. Then grasp the humerus as distal as possible and move it into forward flexion, which should be limited at around 80 to 90 degrees before the clavicle starts to move. If we let go of the fixation and thus allow the clavicle and scapula to move with, we should be able to raise the arm above the head to around about 180 degrees. For extension, the same principles apply, but the arm is moved backwards to around 60 degrees as a norm. Let's now look at abduction and adduction. For abduction, the patient is again in sitting position and we will apply the same proximal fixation as with flexion. Then abduct the arm to around 90 degrees. If we let go of the fixation, we should be able to move the arm further, but we'll eventually have to externally rotate it to reach end range. Abduction and adduction can not only happen in the frontal plane, but also in the transversal plane. We then refer to horizontal abduction and adduction. For horizontal adduction, start with the arm in 90 degrees of forward flexion and support it with one hand. Fixate the scapula at its lateral border and bring the arm towards the midline of the body. With proper fixation of the scapula, you should reach end range at around 20 degrees. Letting go of the scapula will allow you to move further across. Horizontal abduction is minimal at around 15 degrees. You can fixate the clavicle and scapula with your body and hand, then abduct the patient's arm to 90 degrees and bring it into horizontal abduction. At last, let's examine the rotations in the glenohumeral joint. For external rotation, have the patient in upright sitting position. To fixate the shoulder girdle and thus isolate movement in the glenohumeral joint, place your torso on the scapula and the contralateral arm over the patient's chest. The hand of that same arm cups the elbow of the patient to stabilize it in the anatomic position. Then use your other hand to induce external rotation by grabbing onto the wrist of the patient's arm and moving it outwards to approximately 60 degrees. For internal rotation, the patient can sit on the end of the bench. The fixation of the shoulder girdle is then going to be opposite to the one we've seen for external rotation. So your torso fixates the shoulder girdle anteriorly against the clavicle and your arm rests against the scapula. Then the patient's arm is brought behind the back and is lifted off the thorax, which is usually around 100 degrees from the anatomic position. External and internal rotation, as shown in this video, were done in the zero position. They can also be done in the 90 degree abducted position with the patient lying in supine, as we have shown in our video on GERD, the glenohumeral internal rotation deficit, which you can watch by a click in the top right corner. Okay, thanks for watching this basics video. Check out our video on basic assessments in the playlist on the left and make sure to subscribe to our continuously growing channel. I highly advise you check the links in the video description down below to our very own assessment ebook and mobile app, as well as our social media channels where we post every single day. If you like, add subtitles to this video. More info on that in the description as well. And as always, this was Andreas for Physiotutors. See you next time. Bye.